Welcome to Trophy TV. I am joined by Everton legend, Andy Gray. Lovely to see you back here.
Good to be back.
Lovely to see you back.
I'm made up. I'm just looking out there again. And memories come flooding back. It's like it was yesterday. It's like I'd walked out there and the first game I played against Forest, that was my debut, I think. We beat them 1-0. And it's just like coming out now, getting ready to go. It's good to be back. I haven't been back for a long time. Obviously living in the Middle East now. So it's brilliant to be back and good to be in the company of my old mate Sharpie and Reedy and Pat Vandenhal.
Yeah. I remember that debut. You took it on your chest and squared it for Adrian Heath. We beat them 1-0 at the street end.
I beat them 1-0 and I did create the goal for Adrian, who'd been having a bit of a tough time. Yeah. And I remember Graham was injured. He'd got injured in the midweek against Coventry. Yeah. And the cup tie, league cup tie, scoring the winner. And I remember saying to Inchie on that day, listen, you need a goal. I said, just any time the ball comes in the box, anywhere near me, get yourself around me and we'll see if we can work on that. Luckily it happened. They got the goal, we got the winner and that was brilliant. They just went from there. It was great.
Fantastic story. Still an Evertonian? I know you play for Villa and Wolves and people like that, but you always seem to hold Everton in their highest esteem.
Of course, how could you not? This is a proper football club. I came here and played in the most successful period of its history. We shared things. The guys, the punters, the players, we shared things that no other Evertonian shared. Very few downs, amazing highs, FA Cup, League, European Cup Winners' Cup, a fraction away from doing the treble before that lot over the road. That would have been wonderful. That was the only thing missing. I just wish we'd have completed that season winning the treble, and that would have been the first time it'd ever been done. So it would have been nice for us to have won on that lot over the road, but it wasn't to be. But just great memories, and how could I not think of this as my club and being part of it? I always talk about it as we, because that's the way I feel.
Fantastic to hear you say that. Moving forward, obviously, last season, what did you make of last season? Because it was us as fans, we were so optimistic going into the new season. What did you make of it?
Well, everyone was. I mean, we, even us in Qatar, I'm in Qatar with Richard Keys, obviously, and we were doing the thing, a show at the very beginning of the season, and Keyes said to me, we're saying, okay, what do you think? Talking to Evan. I said, well, I'm, you know, new coaches in, and, you know, I'm hoping things will be good. We've lost Lukaku, that's not great. You know, it's going to be a massive void. But we spent 150 million on footballers. I'm hoping that we should be still in the top six and maybe pushing for four. He said, Keyes went, top four. He was one that was so convinced that we were going to make that jump. But it never happened, for whatever reason. I don't know. I didn't think that Koeman ever settled on a system. He never seemed to settle on a formation. He never seemed to settle on an 11. He was always chopping and changing. One day a back three, next day a back four, then one up top, then two up top. The team never got any rhythm into its football. And it struggled badly. And that was, I don't know, again, not being here, I don't know why. He just never seemed to, I don't know whether the players bought into him. That's what it seemed like. Didn't quite buy into what he was doing. So something had to happen, it did. And listen, Sam's a mate of mine. Yeah. I know Sam well. And I actually thought at the time it was going to be a really good appointment, because I thought that Sam would have thought, this is my last chance to go in. Brilliant, the best club he'd ever managed, biggest club he's ever managed, and really make a point and show people that, bang, I know I can do this. And again, I don't know why, it never happened. And in fairness, I don't think Sam conducted his PR as well as he might have done. You know, there were a lot of Evertonians not happy with things he was saying and what have you, and I get that, because this club's synonymous with being successful, and it wasn't being. But he did what he had to do. He settled it. He made us safe and assured our Premier League status and finished one place below where we did the year before. So he did something right, but it wasn't and to the way that Evertonians wanted it to be done. And I get that. I get that 100%. And so did Sam.
Yeah.
So there had to be a change. And they've made the change. I think it's another big gamble for me.
Okay.
I do. I hope I'm... I hope it's something unfounded. But, you know, he's a coach that has a certain reputation. He took Hull down. He didn't do brilliant at Watford. And, you know, we have to hope that this is a perfect fit. You know, sometimes coaches go somewhere and it doesn't work. It's like players.
Yeah.
You can go and play for a club. I came here. No one knew what it was going to be like. It was a perfect fit for me.
Yeah.
Perfect fit. You know, but I might have gone somewhere else and it would have been awful. So I'm hoping that Marco comes in and I know he likes to play football and he'll be working with good quality footballers and he's got money to spend. The club have got money to spend. So he's in a fabulous position, a much better position than most previous Everton managers. Certainly Moisey had nothing to spend every year and did brilliantly for 10 years. So he's going to have the most money to spend. So he has to, you know, show us that it's right. And it's no use. See, I don't think it's any use finishing 8th or 9th next year when we've battered Sam for finishing 8th.
Yeah.
You know, so he's got to hit the floor running, Marco Silva, and I hope he does. And I hope the players buy into him. And his way of playing is conducive to what we like to see at Goodison. We like to see good, fast attacking football. You know, we're not overly bothered about passing the ball around the back. We found that with Roberto Martinez. Roberto did a really good job here in a lot of ways, but we got kind of bored with the pass. We like to see fast attacking football here. And if he gives us that, then, you know, we'll be okay. So I wish him all the luck in the world. I hope he's successful because we've had a couple of years, you know, a bit like Manchester United when they lost Fergie.
Yeah, yeah.
They had a bit of a dip and it was hard to come back. When we lost David Moyes, you know, we had a couple of decent years, but it hasn't quite been the same since in that respect. So we hope that that he can lift it again, as I've said, because I think this is a big season for us. The others are going to go on, the big six. They're going to move on. We have to make sure we're still there with them. So money to be spent, spend it wisely, get them playing, get us competitive in a way that Evertonians like, and he will be very much accepted.
What do you make of Marcel Brand's appointment to director of football? Is it a model that you buy into, or do you just accept that that's the way it's going now because of obviously the game's grown so much?
I don't know what the model's going to be, is the honest answer. If it's the model where the director of football buys all the players that he wants with his staff who have scouted and says to Marco Silva, there's your players, make them play, I don't like it. Because the coach has to have input to who he wants and who he doesn't want, who he wants to keep at the club, who he doesn't, who he wants to buy. If it's the model where Marco Silva and the director of football get together and the director of football says to Marco, who do you want?
Yeah.
What do you want? And Marco Silva says, okay, I need a left back that does this, this and this. I need a midfield player that does this, this and this. I need a centre forward that does this, this and this. If it's that model, fine.
Okay.
I don't mind that. But the coach has to have a massive input. He's working with the players. He knows the way he wants to play his football. So he knows who he wants in his team. If it's the other way, as I said, where the director of football buys them all, says to him, here you go, that's your lot. Yeah. I don't like that model. And I don't think it would be good for Everton to have that model. So I hope there's, you know, a communication between them both where they're both working together and bringing the best players to Everton.
Yeah, I think to be fair to Marcel Brands, I think he said that he's got to agree with Marco Silva because he's got to work with them. Just let me ask you very quickly, Wayne Rooney, it looks as though he's going to move on now from Everton. DC United have been speaking to him for a while. What do you make of the whole, you know, Rooney leaving Everton? Do you think it's the right time? What did you think of him coming back, first of all?
Well, I know from experience because, you know, I like Wayne. I spent, as a teenager in my early 20s, I spent a very successful period at Aston Villa and then left and went back when I was 10 years older. And you're not the same player. It's difficult. Wayne had that. He was a genius when he was a child here. He went away, had an unbelievable career at Manchester United. But then, and I think part of the problem is the expectation, Evertonians thought they were getting the same Wayne back. Yeah. They weren't. And it was always going to be hard. Listen, did he disappoint? Maybe sometimes. But when you look at his stats and his facts, he was terrific. I mean, goals that he scored and the games that he played were up there, probably the top goal scorer.
He lost the top.
There you go. So you can't argue with the stats that say that. But I think Everton have to move on, and I think it's right for Wayne. I think now, at the age he's at, because he's not like Ryan Giggs, he's not the most natural athlete.
No.
He's always had to work very hard at his fitness. Yeah. And that's, sometimes you get lucky, and I wasn't, you know, but I was kind of skinny all my life. And it was easy, but there are some people who have to work really hard at their fitness. I think Wayne's one of them. Alex Ferguson, many years ago, said about Wayne, he has to play football. He's not a good player when he rests him up for a couple of weeks and bring him back again. He wants to play and play and play. And he wasn't going to get that in second way. He wasn't going to play every game, and he wouldn't play every game this year coming in, I'm sure, with Marco Silva. So I think it's, you know, he's been brilliant, a total Everton legend. Evertonians should only remember, I hope, the good things from Wayne, and there were many, many of them. So for him and his family, probably it'll be nice to go and spend a couple of years in the States and just relax and chill and enjoy his football, because he's played football since he was 17 under massive pressure at the two clubs he was at, Everton and United. So go and enjoy it, Wayne. Take your family there, have a, you know, see what the other part of the world looks like, and enjoy it. You deserve to do that.
Thanks very much, Andy Gray. Thank you very much for talking to Toffee TV.
As always, thank you.